And a Herefordshire woman claims that a mobile phone mast has made her medical condition worse.
I started getting flashing lights in my eyes, more severe tinnitus than normal. The ringing in my ears was terrible. Couldn't sleep, I was tossing and turning all night. Something completely new, I started getting itchy skin.
Does being near a mast concern you or not? 7:08 now, and something that may or may not concern you, I don't know. Just listen to this. Mobiles, microwaves, laptops, Wi-Fi even. They all kick out magnetic fields. And now a woman from South Herefordshire claims she developed a severe skin rash after staying near to a mobile phone mast. You can see the pictures on our Facebook page. Diana Bowson from Welsh Newton says she's suffered from electro sensitivity for 15 years, a condition which is created when in regular contact with electricity waves. GPs have been unable to diagnose the problem. She's been explaining to our reporter Julie Tyler why she wants others to be aware of the radiation dangers.
Despite the fact that everything was basically an electrical shutdown, everything was switched off that might affect me, my symptoms actually got worse when I was there. I started getting flashing lights in my eyes, which I haven't had before, more severe tinnitus than normal. The ringing in my ears was terrible. Couldn't sleep. I was tossing and turning all night. Something completely new. I started getting itchy skin. It wasn't a rash to start with. It was itchy skin.
And if we look, you have some images here for us, which can be seen online. Some horrendous red welts across your body, which the rash has come out right across your chest and up your neck, and on your shoulders you've got the most awful scarred mess, really.
Yeah, it started as a rash and it spread very rapidly over a period of a few days, and they actually became burn-like lesions, and not so much blisters, just as if I felt as though I'd had acid thrown at me or I'd been in a fire. It was absolute agony. I put it down to electrosensitivity, but it was also site specific in the sense that I had stayed at home sometimes, and on those occasions I didn't feel itchy, so there was something there.
And what was that something?
After a month, and I spotted a mobile phone mast approximately 200 or 300 yards away from the house, the only thing in that area that emits microwave radiation, then I'm confident that that's what's caused the rash. And I've since discovered that this is actually quite typical. These other people have seen my photos and they say they're typical of rashes and lesions that they've seen in other areas around masts.
Obviously you were being treated by your GP at this time.
Yeah.
What was their reaction to this? What was their diagnosis?
When I first saw the GP, he thought it might be Stevens-Johnson's, but that same day lesions started to appear in my mouth and my throat, so I went to A&E. They didn't give a diagnosis, they just gave me some strong antihistamines, which were effective, and the itchiness and some of the pain from the rash started to go. I tentatively asked, could it be radiation burns from non-ionising radiation from a phone mast, and they said, we don't know, we've never seen that before. All the symptoms are classic symptoms.
Let's look at your reasons for going public at this stage then, Diana.
Recently, David Cameron has said that he'd like to relax the planning laws to allow masts to be put up anywhere. Well, my concerns are not only for people such as myself, but for the general population. There are thousands and thousands of research papers showing that this type of radiation, as from phone masts, does cause health, major serious health risks.
Diana Bowton from Welsh Newton, who's calling for stricter laws imposed on where mobile phone masts are placed. And you can see some pretty gory images on our Facebook page of what happened to her skin. And the way she describes it was awful. On their website, the NHS state the research by the Mobile Telecommunications and Health Research Programme didn't find any evidence to suggest that some people suffer unpleasant symptoms caused by exposure to signals from mobile phones or masts. Was it something you worry about? Let us know.
Also coming up, a Herefordshire woman says she's been burned by radiation from a mobile phone mast.
It started as a rash and it spread very rapidly over a period of a few days, and they actually became burn-like lesions. I felt as though I'd had acid thrown at me or I'd been in a fire. It was absolute agony.
Mobiles, microwaves, laptops and even Wi-Fi, they all kick out magnetic fields. And now a woman from South Herefordshire claims she developed a severe skin rash after staying near to a mobile phone mast. Diana Bowton from Welsh Newton has suffered with electrosensitivity for 15 years, a condition which is created when in regular contact with electricity waves. Now, after staying regularly with a nearby friend who lives near to a mast in Llangrove, she says she developed serious burn-like lesions which GPs were unable to diagnose. She's been explaining to our reporter Julie Tyler why she wants others to be aware of the radiation dangers.
Despite the fact that everything was basically an electrical shutdown, everything was switched off that might affect me, my symptoms actually got worse when I was there. I started getting flashing lights in my eyes, which I haven't had before, more severe tinnitus than normal, the ringing in my ears was terrible, couldn't sleep, I was tossing and turning all night. Something completely new, I started getting itchy skin. It wasn't a rash to start with, it was itchy skin.
And if we look, you have some images here for us, which can be seen online, some horrendous red welts across your body, which the rash has come out right across your chest and up your neck, and on your shoulders you've got the most awful scarred mess, really.
Yeah. It started as a rash and it spread very rapidly over a period of a few days, and they actually became burn-like lesions, and not so much blisters, just as if I felt as though I'd had acid thrown at me or I'd been in a fire. It was absolute agony. I put it down to electrosensitivity, but it was also site specific in the sense that I had stayed at home sometimes, and on those occasions I didn't feel itchy, so there was something there.
And what was that something?
After a month, and I spotted a mobile phone mast approximately 200 or 300 yards away from the house, the only thing in that area that emits microwave radiation, then I'm confident that that's what's caused the rash. And I've since discovered that this is actually quite typical. These other people have seen my photos and they say they're typical of rashes and lesions that they've seen in other areas around masts.
Yeah, have a look at this. If you do get 5 minutes, go and have a look on the Facebook page, because she's really got some nasty rashes, aren't they? It really is. It's a terrible rash all over her neck and a sort of upper part of her chest. On the website, the NHS state that research by the Mobile Telecommunications and Health Research Programme did not find any evidence to suggest some people suffer unpleasant symptoms caused by exposure to signals from mobile phones or masks. There has been a lot of research done into this. But opinion is still kind of divided on it, isn't it? Let's talk to someone who knows a bit more. Dr. Zenon Sinkovic from Public Health England. Good morning.
Good morning.
Do you believe that there is any link to the phone masks and these health problems, these rashes that Diana's got?
Well, I really can't sort of talk specifically about any one case. It's a medical condition. I think it would be wrong of me and improper to try and do so. So I can just talk about generalities. As you say, there has been a lot of research looking at the effects of mobile phones on symptoms. There have been laboratory provocation studies where people reporting their symptoms in their home or in the environment come in and they are given, so provoked, if you like, an exposure with certain frequencies and modulations of signals, and they try and ask them some questions. The first one being, can you tell me when the signal is on? Now, this research, as you've mentioned, the MTHR program, which was done in the UK, some studies were done at University of Essex and King's College in London. And these actually were very high quality studies, and people came in, they did the provocation test, and in terms of could you tell when the signal was on, they couldn't. And did it actually have a sort of association, a consistent sort of response of symptoms to the field? And the answer was no, they didn't. This is why I think, you know, people like the World Health Organization, Public Health England, other authorities around the world sort of think, well, yes, obviously the symptoms are real. And clearly I've been on the website, I've seen Diana's problems with her skin, and it is very distressing, and I agree with you. And I certainly do hope that, you know, she shows recovery soon. But you cannot say there is an association between exposure and the symptoms.
Well, Diana says she suffered from electrosensitivity for a number of years anyway. How common a condition is that?
Well, that's difficult to actually estimate. Again, the MTHR had a study done from the University of Essex, which looked at prevalence in the UK in adults, and they came up around 4%. This is what they were thinking. So in terms of, you know, numbers, it's quite large. But you have to remember, in sort of EHS, electrical hypersensitivity, or whatever you want to call it, it's sort of like a sort of an umbrella term for many different symptoms. So you do go from slight headaches maybe through to migraines. You may go from slight rashes through to something far more severe, and you may just go through tingling and itches through complete loss of control of a limb.
Do you,
so you can imagine there's a large spectrum of differences here.
Yeah, of course. Do you think, though, that we could be having a different conversation, say, 30, 40 years down the line? Because we don't know, do we? This is the thing. We don't know. This is all very... This bombardment of radio waves and, you know, Wi-Fi and mobile phones, this is all very new, isn't it, within the last sort of 20, 30 years?
Well, I mean, really.
People thought smoking wouldn't do them any harm years ago.
Well, Well, no, as I say, Marconi was broadcasting, the BBC had been broadcasting, and they're all radio waves, the same sort of thing, signals, same sort of, you know, roughly the same sort of signals.
But we seem to be in closer proximity to it these days, though.
We were hearing about these symptoms, and it was called microwave sickness then. So it isn't exactly a brand new phenomenon.
But we seem to be in closer proximity to these things with the Wi-Fi actually in our homes.
Or phone in your pocket, constantly near you all the time.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the pattern of exposure is changing, although these sort of levels of exposure are generally not exchanging. And as the technology on phones in particular improves, if you like, the power they put out, the power you could absorb in your body, tends to go down.
OK. It's fascinating stuff. Thank you very much for talking to us, Dr. Zenon Sinkovic from Public Health England. Your thoughts on this? Have a look, actually. Definitely go and have a little look, because it's a really nasty rash,
nasty.
Isn't it?
Awful.
If you've had a similar thing, please do get in touch. And do you think... Do you know what? There is a whole load of products out there. I had a little look about this. They call it electromagnetic smog, this kind of... You know, all the radio waves that are in the world. And you can buy hats and things like that that have, like, wire mesh in it to protect your brain. Yeah, there's all sorts of things you can buy. So, clearly, plenty of people think it's a genuine thing. 6 minutes to eight.
A woman from South Herefordshire claims to have developed horrific skin lesions after staying next door to a mobile phone mast. Diana Boughton from Welsh Newton calls comes as David Cameron looks to ease the rules and regulations on the masts. She claims that sufferers are being made to feel like freaks as the effects of radiation waves aren't being recognised.
The World Health Organization have for years on their website that it doesn't exist, or that it does exist, but it must be psychological. They're saying that it doesn't cause cancer. Every time I've said anything about this to a doctor of any type, they raise their eyebrows and they just say, I'm sorry, I've never heard of that, or I don't know anything about that.
The NHS state on their website that no evidence has been found to suggest some people suffer from unpleasant symptoms caused by exposure to signals from mobile phones or their masts. You can see a few photos of Dan on our Facebook page, facebook.com/BBC Hereford and Worcester.
Also coming up, it's been dubbed an electromagnetic smog, but rubbished by some.
I started getting flashing lights in my eyes, more severe tinnitus than normal. The ringing in my ears was terrible. Couldn't sleep. I was tossing and turning all night. Something completely new. I started getting itchy skin.
Now a Herefordshire woman claims the magnetic fields given out by mobile phone masts have been making her health condition worse. A Herefordshire woman who claims she's got health problems from contact with electrical waves is calling for tighter regulations on mobile phone masts.
Now, it's been dubbed an electromagnetic smog. We're talking about the magnetic fields kicked out by mobiles, microwaves, laptops and Wi-Fi. And now a woman from South Herefordshire claims a mobile phone mast has aggravated her health problems. Diana Bowson from Welsh Newton says she's suffered from electrosensitivity for 15 years, a condition which is created when in regular contact with electricity waves. She's been explaining to our reporter Julie Tyler why she wants others to be aware of the radiation dangers.
Despite the fact that everything was basically an electrical shutdown, everything was switched off that might affect me, my symptoms actually got worse when I was there. I started getting flashing lights in my eyes, which I haven't had before, more severe tinnitus than normal. The ringing in my ears was terrible. Couldn't sleep. I was tossing and turning all night. Something completely new. I started getting itchy skin. It wasn't a rash to start with. It was itchy skin.
And if we look, you have some images here for us, which can be seen online. Some horrendous red welts across your body, which the rash has come out right across your chest and up your neck, and on your shoulders you've got the most awful scarred mess, really.
Yeah, it started as a rash and it spread very rapidly over a period of a few days, and they actually became burn-like lesions, and not so much blisters, just as if I felt as though I'd had acid thrown at me or I'd been in a fire. It was absolute agony. I put it down to electrosensitivity, but it was also site specific in the sense that I had stayed at home sometimes, and on those occasions I didn't feel itchy, so there was something there.
And what was that something?
After a month, and I spotted a mobile phone mast approximately 200 or 300 yards away from the house, the only thing in that area that emits microwave radiation, then I'm confident that that's what's caused the rash. And I've since discovered that this is actually quite typical. These other people have seen my photos and they say they're typical of rashes and lesions that they've seen in other areas around masts.
Now, Diane says that the doctor thought it was another condition and staff at A&E couldn't tell her what it was. You can have a look for yourself. I mean, who knows what it is or what's causing it, but it really is a horrible, horrible rash, isn't
it?
There's some photos of it on our Facebook page. You can have a look at it for yourself. Professor Ollie Johansson works at an experimental dermatology unit in Stockholm, Sweden, and he's on the phone now. Morning.
Good morning. It's a great honor to participate in this morning's program, and I do hope all your listeners are having a beautiful day ahead of them.
Well, that's very nice of you. It's a great honor
to
have you here, Professor. Now, is this
thank you.
Is this a condition that you've come across?
Well, of course, in this specific case, to judge the exact causes for those medical problems over telephone is, of course, not possible. Then one needs to meet the person, scrutinize the person and her environment much closer. However, this woman's symptoms are among those classically found in victims of other types of radiation damage, like from radioactive compounds, X-ray, strong UV light and radar beams, and early studies from the 1980s and 90s done here at the Karolinska Institute by myself and my co-workers indicated dramatic effects in skin cells after exposure to the type of microwaves for wireless gadgets we are discussing today. And the increases we saw in so-called cutaneous mast cells and their content of the bioactive molecule histamine can on its own explain this woman's whole symptomatology. And furthermore, a colleague to me in Japan, Dr. Hajime Kimata, already in 2002 exposed eczemas to mobile phone radiation in human beings, and they then got worse, clearly pointing to that if you at least are a Japanese man or woman with an eczema, you should not allow yourself to be exposed to the radiation from, for instance, base stations like this tower she's mentioning.
Okay, so if that's the case, why, bear in mind how many of these base stations are around, how many of us carry gadgets around that use radio waves, how come if you're saying this could possibly be caused by that, why aren't more people presenting themselves with these similar symptoms and conditions?
Well, they are, as a matter of fact, and if you look on countries, including the UK and all over the world, you have a range between approximately 3% up to nearly 20% in some situations, with persons reporting exactly the same kind of symptoms, and we then call them electro hypersensitive. In Sweden, this is an officially recognized functional impairment, so you can then get various forms of accessibility measures, which then alleviates these problems, hopefully. And we have also just recently done a study where we have looked on vicinity to wireless radiation sources like towers and the prevalence of various health problems. And we have done this together with the University of Copenhagen in Denmark. And it turns out that significant associations were seen for nearby mobile phone towers with, for instance, cognitive, head, eye, body and skin problems.
So
is
there anything we can actually do about it, though? Or is it that if you are too close to these things, you're going to get these problems? Because phone masts, you know, the radiation, Wi-Fi, it's all over the place now.
Oh, it is. And the radiation you find everywhere. And you certainly aim at the core issue here. What should we do? And should you and I do it and the society? Or should we just leave this poor woman alone, allowing her to face the problems on her own? And of course not. And in Sweden, if she would be living here, she would then have the possibility to go to the municipality office and ask for various forms of accessibility measures, like shielding of her apartment or house where she lives.
Okay, good to speak to you. It's really fascinating stuff, isn't it? Professor Ollie Johansson at the Experimental Dermatology Unit in Stockholm in Sweden. Probably the politest guest I think we've ever had on, don't you think?
Yes. What a lovely way to do it. It's an honour to be on the show.
Now, on the website, the NHS state that research by the Mobile Telecommunications and Health Research Programme didn't find any evidence to suggest that some people suffer these kind of things. But as we said, have a look and decide for yourself. Look at the picture on our Facebook page.
They are quite shocking pictures, actually.
Because there's certainly something quite nasty going on there, isn't there?